Obviously, Snake's going to live a little bit longer than Battlefield. He's going to get platform combos as well. But Peach also, to be able to float in the middle of that platform and cover tech rolls, so strong in her own right.
Now, for those of you unfamiliar, this is a grand finals match. In other words, Mew Ace has to win two sets in order to win the tournament, but Salem only needs to win one more set to win that trophy and $6,000.
We've only seen Salem lose three games this entire top eight.
Really?
Only one full set. So far, Mewdace would have to double that. Only losing two to MVD and one to Mewdace in winners finals. This is going to be incredibly difficult and not how you want to see that start.
Strange flub from Mewdace right there, trying to get his bearings. The thing is, too, a lot of players running through a huge loser's bracket run, some players, it gives them momentum, but eventually, you know, you can only handle so much. Your body has fatigue, it has stamina, and every player can only play a certain amount.
It's been a long weekend for everyone here. You know, this is possibly the final or penultimate match here. And this has been something that these players have built towards for a long time, this tournament toughness.
Once again, going for that forward air edge grab, but Salem very, very good at mixing up his recovery to make sure it's a little more ambiguous. Up smash in there. But see, on this stage, too, the up smash gets blocked by the top platform.
Yeah, there's a lot of coverage from that. The mind games of Snake become that much more layered.
I can actually hear those controllers clacking so loudly from here. These guys are going at it. Ups, okay, turnip barely missing. Again, that B reverse. Salem very cleverly avoiding that Peach Bomber, throwing his own Bomber out, but it's not, Nita's gonna hit.
We see the upward swing there. That's gonna be one of the awesome changes for Peach in this game, is the fact that how you angle that is gonna be to show whether it's gonna be the racket, the frying pan, or the golf club.
He really caught that turnip in such a slick fashion. This is really a new breed of Snake right here. This is actually very impressive to see.
This is a four-week-old Snake. I want to point this out. This is of such importance. Salem has not been playing this character very long and is now sitting in grand finals, found himself in loser's finals of Nimbus. This man is on an absolute tear.
I wonder how four-week-old real-life Snakes look. Are they fully grown?
Probably much smaller.
But this one is. Oh, two back airs, but he's actually somehow living. Salem has had such impressive recoveries this whole game. Mew Ace now has to sort of face a three-stock lead after an unfortunate SD in the beginning, going very, very high for a hard read.
Oh my god, again, again.
How is he still recovering? Oh my goodness.
And once again, we see the parasol not strong enough in its individual hits to break the cipher. Now at 220, this man's playing Brawl in 2019.
Is that a percent or a gas price? My god. Oh! He's actually up to the shield. Okay, 237, I thought.
But the thing is, I think he actually C4'd himself. Mewdace was not able to take that stock out himself.
I think so. Hey, if anyone's going to do it, better be by your own hand, right?
Right, right.
Keep that confidence alive. But now Mewdace got a lot of percent really quickly off this stock.
But he can't take too much more damage. We talk about how light Peach is and how strong Salem has been at getting these up tilt reads.
Off a down throw, Peach. Oh, millimeters away from getting that forward air.
And that's the struggle. Peach can't really go any higher.
Oh, my gosh.
Goodbye. Yeah, goodbye.
It literally, he runs out of options right there. Mewdace looking very stoic, still face.
Recovering against Nikita is really difficult. You can interrupt
any character.
You can interrupt the hitbox itself with a hitbox of your own, but if the Snake cancels it, the hitbox returns. So you're able to hit it, swing the Nikita over top again, and then let it go, and then suddenly you have another explosive falling on you.
It's just the speed of the move, right? Because like you said, you can swing it back, have it cover the ledge, and then even if you're feeling it's not going to work out, you can cancel it with R, and it falls down vertically. It's just such a reliable move for Snake. Oh, wait a minute. Okay, staying with Peach. Same characters all throughout. Snake, Peach, once again. I'm expecting them to go to Pokemon Stadium this time, unless he runs it back to Battlefield. Oh, Kalos! Okay, again, we've only seen this stage about two or three times this whole tournament.
Yeah, we saw this initially in the Snake Ditto in the winner's semis between MVD and Salem. MVD coming out on top in that game. I'm wondering if this is going to have the same advantage for Mewdace.
Well, he's been content to just let the grenades do all the work that he needs. He rolls back, waits for their action, and then puts the appropriate bomb based upon that. So right now, notice how Mew Ace is just putting so many arrows in his face. He's happy to just roll away, reset to neutral. People don't realize how important resetting to neutral is when it comes to these top level matches.
And that's the crazy thing about those down airs, is typically you see a shield stab from that. We saw multiple down airs on Salem's shield, and he was able to shift the shield up and avoid that. And now, really just starting to tack on this damage, slowly but surely, 52%, about a 30% difference between them.
One pattern I've seen is grenade up smash second grenade, because then they go boom, boom, boom. Each one explodes in quick succession, and your opponent's concerned with not getting hit by the bombs. But in their concern, they forget that they have your actual opponent coming towards you with either a grab or an aerial, and that's the trick and then, Snake wants to put.
And then just then, even when Mudaze guessed correctly and got the grab, the grenade was quickly behind it and exploded on contact.
Another thing, too, is like per conversion, right? Like even in neutral, they might be winning an equal amount of times, but Snake's able to get way more percent per conversion win.
Which is crazy to think about because the damage output for Peach is absolutely massive.
It depends on the character, I think. Like I said, we're not seeing too many of these incredible. We saw some down air loops or some down tilt loops, but not able to quite close them out. I'm not sure if that's Salem DI in a strange way. Two canceled forward tilts, but not enough to kill when Peach responds to the forward air. And staying down, is he gonna recover?
Going low, he's too low again.
Oh.
No. And we've seen it a couple times now where Salem just kind of hangs out on ledge, F-tilts his shield a couple times. Really seems like he's starting to play with his food a little bit. Very confident in this potential second-to-last game of this Grand Finals.
Thankfully, the SD was near kill percent, but he sort of lost his lead. Now, getting it back right here, but still early percent, he really needed to kill Snake right there and run away with it. Because when you're at this even percent, like, this is still Snake. He's not going to die until it's like, well, 150.
Twice now we've seen him live to about 175. His inability to close out those stocks early are really costing him this set.
And now trying to get his up airs in question here. That Snake with a very, very heavy character, you can sort of do his up air chains for low percents like that. Beautiful drag down, almost hitting the forward air to hit the dagger of the combo. 58 right now for Salem, responding with his own forward tilt. Down throw, back air from Mudaze.
Oh, the grenade. Edge guard
C4. I swore up air was going to be there.
It really seemed like if he was going to commit to that hard option, but you just saw Snake plummet past him.
All right, Mudaze is definitely picking a lot better options for approaching here. Rather than trying just down-airing on shield, he's really waiting right now for the option that Salem's going to do. He's also noticing that Salem isn't one to air dodge, so he's just hitting him, right? Just like that.
Nair again, but that's the difficult part of this counter pick.
Oh!
Sides are so wide, but Peach can reach out there. She can't reach him vertically, but she can
reach him
horizontally.
Deep right now reach from Salem, landing the C4 on Peach. I'm not sure if it's still on her. She might have actually
avoided. Did you see the timing on that turnip grab?
Insane. Oh wait, re-grab with the frame one grenade combo breaker, if I've ever seen one. Up air gonna kill! Salem now poised to win this match if he can control it, but Mudaze coming down with a fresh stock. This is the highest lead he's had all set.
However, this is the most confident we've seen Mudaze play so far. He's got this lead, he's gotta be able to capitalize on it.
We're waiting one more second here. Now, great up tilt, it just shows you how powerful that move is. Chasing him on shield, dash attack out. One grenade.
Uh-oh, Saturn.
Two grenades.
Shields are gone. Saturn in hand. Shields are gone, but he throws it away.
You gotta pick your options very carefully here. Salem has now equalized percent in seconds.
We see him get the setup. We see the Nikita drop. He's back to ledge. He's gonna have to figure out a way past Peach.
Alrighty, going high again. Mute Ace still not able to find Salem in the sky. So good, avoiding all the bombs.
Oh, but he does get caught with the grab. Forward throw, we're gonna see the grenade and a Nikita.
Oh, there it is. Will one more do it? 110 right now.
The mortars are out.
Meanwhile, Salem at his own very high percent wave landing back. The forward air.
It's not gonna be enough.
Oh my goodness, Salem is still alive. B reverse off the top to get away from it. Blowing up the C4, the back air.
Oh, again.
Are you serious?
Too big.
What?
The patience, the empty hops.
Dude, no, he back here to reverse the hitbox.
Throw not going to do it, but he's off stage again.
If Salem wins this, I have to hand it to him. What incredible, just, my God, he almost hit that.
He sent himself a little bit too high. He double jumped because he thought Peach was going to go above him from the grenade knockback. Cancels the Nikita.
Oh, Snake at full range. Mudaze is this close from equalizing the set. The back air will do it.
He held his ground the entire time, never committing to the corner, knowing how strong Salem was playing out of that, saying, I'm going to lay this back here over here for you over and over again, finally catching the defensive role.
Mudaze saying, you're not going to get rid of South Florida that easily. I'm winning it here for my town. I'm winning it here because I want to be the best. I can do it. I've proved it. Just another snake in the garden for me.
Let's not get ahead of ourselves. We saw this in winner's final as well.
Oh, he was
able to get one game. Will he be able to double that ever? Will he be able to possibly have six times the result of game one? He has to win three games in this set. Three games in the reset.
But of course, with any reset, the slate is wiped clean. And right now, like you said, Grant, winner's finals was a 3-1. I think in this exact order, with Salem winning game one, Mute Ace winning game two. Can he prevent the repeat?
It's an early damage. He's getting Snake off the ground so quickly. He's not allowing Snake to set up. 85 now. Going high. Going to cover it again with the back air, though. 100% to 10.
Okay, Mutase. Okay, Mutase. Really, really good opening from here. He's waiting for the downer now. The patience, the adaptation is really coming out.
New Peach, who dis?
I noticed how he would go for down throw back air so often, but now down throw on the platform, waiting for the option. Great forward air.
Spacing, ladies and gentlemen.
This is the aggression you want to see right here. Down air always missing right here. Salem going for some risky options.
No grenade. That's going to be really hard for him to get down. Gets back to stage, though. That's the big thing. If Snake isn't able to pull that grenade, Peach can really just run wild with these combos.
I guarantee you, if Mutase would have lost that last game, the play style would be completely different here. More careful, more dejected. But because he got that momentum boost, that confidence he needed to say, you know what? If I can win one, I can win two more.
He almost has a full stock lead now. Salem trying to close this out as quickly as possible. The Nair! Single hit! Last hit of Nair closing that out.
The last one's all that matters, right? Dash attacking through the turnip, grabbing it also. Interesting mechanics on dash attack.
Intangible arms, baby. Intangible arms.
He wants to get a down tilt on Peach, but Mutase is not giving it to him. Every time he misses, that's 30%. But Mutase now missing his forward smash finisher, which would have definitely killed Nikita, doing 9%. Four hits of Nair to 63. Wow. So much percent output. Nikita now going
up. Oh, my God.
Salem equalizing it in seconds, as he always has all tournament.
Oh, the platform saving him.
The platform. I don't think he was aware of that. He thought it was going to be a little more forward. Wasn't enough. Running, stopping it with that up tilt. So frightening to deal with.
Especially with that float height, too. Salem can sneak underneath that with that low dash.
Waiting here once again. Back air from Mutase. Not going to kill Salem quite yet.
Going to go high. You see the B reverse. Where's the explosion?
Oh, nice. Tomahawk. I thought back here, back to there might have been better, but I'm not too sure.
Not from center stage. Not going to be early enough. Mutase fully aware of his percents. Got to be getting those back airs again, just standing in center stage, fully confident.
184 from Snake. Air dodging. Winky Eyes turnip, one of the stronger ones. Can he get this kill? Back air, just to say I back aired you. But now Mutase finding himself in the lead this game three.
I want to point out the brilliance of Mutase forcing that initial air dodge that pushed Snake off stage. The turnip actually trading with the grenade. If it hadn't, the grenade would have exploded and killing Snake in the process. So Salem forced into that air dodge. Brilliant
really
play from Mutase.
Interesting if Salem did only the first hit of forward tilt, wanted to lead into maybe an up air or up tilt. And there it is. One stock apiece, one game apiece. Grand final set one. Very pivotal point right here.
How many times have we seen that up tilt come in so clutch for Salem?
I've literally lost count. All right, great use of downer into back air.
All right, we see even percent so far, but Salem having more time to set up now. Unfortunately, Mutase is going to come in and hit him with that pressure. Not really get a chance to put a dropper grenade or a C4.
Early percent trades, all you really need.
His ability to call out with those multi-hit aerials have given him such an advantage in this set.
Right. Oh, going for the fat up smash, a little bit risky. No way!
God, the timing! Salem the God!
And that, my friends, might very well be the dagger that he needed. The last laugh in a set, in a tournament that has been so grueling to watch with these players, to land the ballsiest forward smash I've seen all tournament. I wonder how Mutase will respond.
That's the Call of Duty killstreak bonus. You've seen him use all these other mechanics, and then finally the RPG get loaded out. Boom, right on ledge.
Honestly, he called him out, and that was that a two-frame pretty much?
So two-framing is in the general sense is actually a little bit wider in this game. Parasol makes things difficult to get around Peach, obviously, but it is a wider window than we saw in Smash 4.
And we have now potentially the last game of this whole tournament, unless Mutase has anything to say about that. Great 64% string, 76, first 10 seconds, and he's stopping right now. Dash attack from Salem to close it out before blowing himself up with a grenade.
Yeah, we saw the shield. He was trying to time it to get the parry on the grenade itself. Wasn't able to get it. Quick little soft back air, forcing him back into the same position off stage again. Mutase has to find his way down. Gets grabbed immediately, though.
I remember in the Brawl days, they would actually call that that back air the sleeping bag because that hitbox was massive. A little hard to hit in this game. Just like that, Mutase now with half the percent of Salem.
See the up smash in neutral. Yeah. Gonna get the grenade push.
Salem pulls out grenades and then uses the up smash for timing as to when to throw it.
It says, don't touch my shield. Double up tilt.
Oh! That platform actually saved him because Salem was ready for that back air.
Uh-oh.
Oh, wait a minute.
Uh-oh.
Oh, this is tiny. But Salem, of course, as long as he doesn't use a shield, forwarder right here. He's happy to stay alive as long as he can, get his shield back as it grows naturally.
He says, how dare you try to use bombs against the munition expert?
I mean, he did use a bomb with a bazooka last game. I don't blame him.
And that's really the first
time. Oh, no. Back throw will kill right there. Odd whiff from Mudez.
We've seen the first time RNG really benefit Mudez there. We've only seen a couple of stitch faces, and that's the first time we've seen any kind of a bomb.
Right. It really speaks to Snake. Wait, to not die from up air right there? Oh, every hit of Nair is tacking on right now. Mudez coming down. Forward air impossibly still not killing, even from that side of the stage.
Where's it coming? Where is he going? Oh, there's the grenade, too.
Oh, even and now Salem's playing the cat and mouse game. Chase me. Try to get a Nair falling out from the shield. The Nair will kill right there.
I really like the step off of the platform there from Mudez. If he'd been caught in a tech trap situation, they're really difficult, especially on the size of that platform with the size of Snake's hitboxes.
Okay, up smash on shield. He's trying to find a C4 to eat away. Nearly getting a conversion off that.
I wasn't sure if that was going to be a shield stab or just a shield break.
Catch and turf in between. Wow, back throw. Nikita is going to kill. Oh! And that's how good that move is. Even if you miss it, you have enough time to quickly cancel and run away. Sort of reset once it gets to neutral.
And he's starting to push the stock lead, or this percent lead further and further.
Oh,
still gonna convert.
Man, Salem on tournament point right here. Will he run away with this win going 2-1 up in this grand final set? As we just saw in Winners, all hits down are going there. Another dash attack, another grenade. He's putting too much right now for Mudez to handle.
Like clockwork, as the time ticks down, the percent ticks up. Salem is all about first place right now.
Oh,
another dash attack there. This is going to be dangerous. One up tilt will close this for Salem right
away.
Now.
Air dodging, wait a minute.
Oh, he's low, he's low, he's low. Not again.
Barely living once again. Nair, okay. Oh, wait, well, the grenade blew him up. Is that what he wanted? Oh, oh.
The grenade again.
The trades are not what he needs right here. The air dodge grenade still living at 157. Turnip not hitting. Waiting for the up air. So much movement right now from Salem. Not even air dodging. He is one up tilt away from winning Ultimate Gamer Miami.
Here we go. He's going to have to find his way down.
Oh, he blew himself up.
Before. He thought he was going to be close enough. But still, one up tilt will finish this.
Imagine this comeback from Mudez right now.
Out of shield.
Imagine the relief he will feel if he gets this string right now.
Watch out for the C4.
Avoiding every bomb. Salem is waiting.
C4 again.
Which C4 will do his bidding?
Oh, I thought he was going to go for the up air finish there.
And
the
Salem!
C4 finish. Salem is your Ultimate Gamer Miami champion.
And let's give it up for our champion of Ultimate Singles, Salem!
For a man that just separated from his team, I do not think he's going to go unsponsored for